Sales too.
Can you chase Ken Breslin down the hallway with the camera?
Some of us are working.
Is this thing on? Let me get a soul clap.
She never has the camera on when you need it. That was some funny shit.
I thought that was rather wimpy.
We are about, obviously, helping people prosper and enjoy what they do. This company, again, you know, was created because there were no companies out there that I personally thought I would enjoy my day working at. So, you know, we work really hard and we spend a lot of time together. I see you guys more than I see my family, definitely, good, bad, or indifferent. So, you know, we have to enjoy working hard and everything else that comes along with it, right? Let's go.
Is it on? How do I look? What's up, guys? Episode 100 is here, and I'm excited to tell you the backstory. A lot of you have seen the last 99 episodes, or some of them at a minimum, and a lot of you guys ask me all the time, why, Jay? Why did you start a vlog? Well, I think we should start off there. So, it's December 2016, and it's an interesting time at the company. It's an interesting time in the industry, and being the innovator that I believe that I am, I decided that I needed to shake things up a little bit, right? I started Saber at the end of 2010. When we came on the scene, a lot of other companies in the industry started to follow suit. We'd open an office here, other companies would open an office there. I think that we forced a lot of the companies that have been in the industry that were a little traditional and I don't want to say stale, but I'll use the word stale because that will give people watching the impression that I'm trying to give. We basically came on the scene trying to be thoughtful about where the world was going. That was 8 years ago. So December 2016, I decided to kind of take it up a notch and to create a vlog. Now, that's a pretty ballsy move in commercial real estate, if I don't say so myself. I knew by putting myself out there, I'd have a lot of critics, get a lot of criticism, definitely get some positive feedback from people who understood social media, understood video, and the impact it can have. But I knew there'd be a lot of people out there that like to, quite honestly, talk shit about it. And that actually drove me more to do it. I never want to be considered ordinary. Kind of a risk taker. I'm definitely unique for the commercial real estate industry. And that's pretty much what Saber is all about. Now, I happen to reside at the intersection of commercial real estate and digital media, and that becomes more and more relevant every day that goes by. So the reasoning behind starting the vlog was to basically just draw awareness to Saber. I was willing to put myself out there and at the risk of having negative feedback, as I already mentioned, in order for my team to get the limelight, if you will. It worked. I'm happy to say that today all of the people in the industry recognize and appreciate what we're doing at Saber and the fact that we're really, really good, like a lot of the other companies that focus on the same space that we do, but we're a little bit different. We march to the beat of our own drum. We take tremendous pride in what we do, and we're so passionate that it doesn't feel like work. Now, you might say, Jay, how do you find the time to keep up with developing your personal brand, Saber's social media presence, the vlog Real Saber? And the answer is I work 24/7. I was doing that before I started a vlog, so nothing's new there. The only difference is I'm able to have some more fun now. I've always been a very creative individual, and retail real estate only allows you to be so creative. So the vlog has been an amazing outlet for myself and my team. So it's all kind of started right around this time, like I said, 2016, when it was the holidays, and I decided that I was going to start a vlog. Vlogs became something that were being talked about at the time, and it was the exact tool that I was looking for to generate awareness. So I had a friend at the time come over the house who was in television, and I started to pick his brain because I did not have any clue where to start. All I knew was I was going to do it, and I was going to do it in January. When I set my mind to something, I just do it pretty quickly. I was not by any means trying to get this perfect, and I think if you go back and look at episode number one, you'll realize that really quickly. So he told me what camera to buy. I went out and got the camera. I'm speaking into that camera right now, 2 years later. And we went on to just start recording, basically, recording whatever it was that was going on. We had somebody, actually a receptionist at the company, would carry around the camera, follow me around in the first few episodes. And we had a friend that we met through mutual friends, essentially, edit the first videos, throw them together, and we would shoot them out on Fridays, and there you go. That's how the vlog started. As time went on, we started to get a little better at it. I started to be more comfortable on camera, and we started to elevate our game. I subscribed to the Gary Vee message of document, don't create. So we basically just flew by the seat of our pants, and it was super interesting. So many things have happened as a result of this that I could have never anticipated. So much in my life has changed in the last 2 years, and I have a lot of it documented on camera. I go back and look at episode one, I barely recognize myself. If I didn't start to record my life on camera, I could never measure all of these things. I could literally go back for the last 2 years to any week and see what I was doing, what I looked like, who was on my team, what they looked like, whatever. You get the point. From there, things started to get super interesting, right? People started to understand the concept of the vlog. We started to get a lot more positive feedback in the industry. And what was interesting to me is there, very shortly after the vlog started to become pretty prominent, I could never walk into a conference room for a meeting with the other party or parties at the meeting not recognizing me. And that tool alone, I'm giving up a little trade secret here, but that little tip alone is amazing and has given us such a leg up. Because when you walk into a conference room and people think they know you already, boy, is it easier to do business. And that is one of the amazing things I learned along the way with Real Saber. But let's get into it. Let's get into the actual episodes a little bit. Let's get into using social media for accountability. Let's get into the interesting people that I've met along the way, the Gary Vaynerchuks of the world, the Tyler Harrises, the list goes on. I could really name a lot of people. And I'm realizing that the majority of the audience watching this vlog right here probably doesn't even understand or recognize a lot of the names that I'm actually using here. And that falls a little bit more into the creative side of things, the social media, the personal branding side of things. And I want everybody to realize that this is not the end. We are going to continue vlogging. We're just retiring Real Saber because the same way that I like to innovate, I like to evolve, right? I like to stay uncomfortable. If you're not constantly doing things that are uncomfortable, you're not growing. And the last 2 years, I've focused so much on the growth of Sabre, the personal growth of myself, the growth of everything in my life. And I think if you just watch the previous episodes leading up to 100, it's very, very obvious how much this has changed me. But I want to talk a little bit about putting yourself out there, right? My buddy Tyler Harris, who I mentioned, has this concept of who am I, right? Who am I to walk around the streets of New York City with a person following me with a video camera? And how egotistical must I be to actually do that? And I hear that from people time to time. And I can totally understand and appreciate people feeling that way. I really can, because those people don't know how uncomfortable it is to actually do it. So I think if you were to actually take a camera and walk around the streets of New York City and have other people looking at you like you're crazy, I think you'll realize it's actually not very egotistical. It's quite humbling. I cannot possibly shake enough hands in a day in order to accomplish what I'm looking to accomplish, which is making a mark on the commercial real estate industry, okay? And this tool has allowed me to do that in ways I never thought would be possible. So when I started in the business 18 years ago, I made it a point to go out and shake everybody's hand, attend as many events as I possibly could, and just overall grind and meet the people in the business that I knew I'd be able to have a relationship for a very long time. Now I've done that, and I also realize that the world's changing. The world of retail is changing. The world of real estate is changing. Everything is changing. And I actually think that a lot of people in our industry do not have any idea how much everything is actually changing. I think that people who do not realize how important it is to have a personal brand that connects to an audience, to use the most important tool that we have today that I'm holding in my hand to your advantage, to get in front of people and differentiate yourself from your competition. If you don't understand how to do these things in the future, you're going to be irrelevant. You're going to be invisible. I look forward to the next chapter here and the new vlog, which will be called Future Proof. What does that mean to me? I'm using tools like this camera that I'm speaking into right now, like this smartphone, to future proof myself. I'll get more into that in the first episode of the new vlog, Future Proof, but for now, you can understand the reason that I'm elevating and I'm retiring Real Sabre. I want to provide more value. I want to make more of an impact on this community. I want people to stop being so afraid to say, Jay, listen, man, I would never do it, but I know why you're doing it, and respect to you for putting yourself out there. I respect the fact that you're not so concerned with what other people think in the industry that you're going to stop from doing things that you want to do. And that's the message that I want to put out here today. I think that if people are going to live in fear of other people's opinions, you're going to have a lot of regrets in life. You're not going to achieve a fraction of what you could have achieved if you were willing to put yourself out there. So episode 100 is a message. It's an open letter, if you will, to the commercial real estate community to start getting real. I've been on a lot of podcasts recently. I have a podcast. I've been a guest on many people's podcasts. I enjoy doing that. I love speaking to people, especially like-minded people that are also thinking about their legacy, putting their mark on the universe, and doing things differently. Not following suit, okay? And I think that it's, again, very important for us to realize that the world is changing. Cutting corners, not looking out for the best interests of your client, those things are going to shortly be a thing of the past. We're dealing with a good economy right now. That's going to change. That's going to change in the next 12 to 18 months. And that means that the people who are having a tough time now are no longer going to be in the business. And I'm not rooting for that. I never look for positives in somebody else's negative, right? So I'm not looking for that. I'm just being realistic. I'm just being honest about what's coming. And there's a lot of opportunities in a downturn. And when you've cut your teeth and focused really hard at being good at what you do, you benefit from those downturns because a lot of the competition gets weeded out. And that's what's going to happen in the commercial real estate industry in the next, call it 12 to 18 months. I'm just being a voice for the community. I'm just being honest, you know, putting my expertise out there for people to listen to and do with what they'd like. But you know, all I want to say to you guys is I encourage all of you to start focusing on how to get yourselves out there, how to differentiate yourself, and not be so concerned with what others think. If you're so concerned about what others think, you may actually lose in a major way, okay? And that's kind of what I want to leave you with. And I look at it as my responsibility to educate, to bring attention to things that are happening in the world that can afford people the opportunity to take their business, take their careers to the next level. At this stage of my life, I genuinely enjoy helping other people. And there are plenty of people watching this that are in the commercial real estate business, that are in the digital media business, that are just out there in the universe that I've interacted with and tried to help in any way possible just by bouncing things off me, picking my brain. I hate that term, but picking my brain, whatever it is. But again, I just want everybody to understand that I'm super appreciative for the positive feedback that we've received as a result of doing these videos. I really, really enjoy the direction that we're going, the direction that Sabre's going. You know, we're built for this new world, and I encourage everybody out there to start really thinking about what that means. Happy to field any calls. You can hit me on email, you can hit me on Instagram, YouTube, we're all over the place. Look forward to launching this new vlog, Future Proof, doing some big things with that. Before I go, I'd like to ask everybody who sees people that are actually picking up this thing, using it in a meaningful way, putting themselves out there on video, to give some respect to those people. You know what? Maybe they deserve a little bit of respect because they're actually doing things that they see as a means to an end. What do I mean by that? In the distance, I see my two sons on my computer monitor. And at the end of the day, the reason that I put myself out there is so I can give them the life they deserve, okay? It's not so I become a household name. It's not so I can go out and have people recognize who I am. All of those things are insignificant to me. The reason that I do it is that is for the sole purpose of getting to know more people, for people to understand that I work really hard and do the right thing, and that Sabre deserves a crack at the business that we pursue, and that we are gonna go above and beyond, which is why our term, Beyond Real Estate, is starting to really connect with our business 8 years later. So I just wanna leave everybody with gratitude, immense gratitude. Thank you so much for following along for the last 2 years, and I look forward to the future. Enjoy episode 100. Thank you. Pull up outside, I'm right here. That's what she like, it's my year. Yes, my time, it's my year. Yes, my time, whoa.